this very almost religious time when we discovered psychedelics and marijuana, and we broke with that 50s, 40s dominant fascist culture. It didn't last because we were doing free radio, and there was free, everything was free for a moment, and we were in that moment, and we were the comic voice of that moment. And when that stopped, we had nowhere to go.
Hold it there, Phil. Run that back.
How far?
Just where the boy starts to back up. I want to see if we can't intercut that with my reaction.
Kid's real good there. I mean, it's going to be tough to cut away on that line.
How do we do it so cheap? Well, it's easy, friends. Because the Firesign Theater does anything for anybody at any time. So long, of course, as we have complete control.
So now, long.
More about that from
So long.
Our Italian friend over here.
Say hello to our many, many registered fans out there in the United Snakes of America. Yes, it's great fun being a radio disc jockey and a member of America's most beloved underground comedy group. It's done wonders for me. My body's in great shape now. I'm dressing pretty snappy. My blues have been rocked away. Wouldn't you agree with me, Phil Austin?
Hi, I'm Les Thompson, and here it is, the big number one on the Boss 30. No, that's just a joke. Seriously, friends, I'm Bob Firesign, owner and general operator of Bob Firesign Chevrolet.
We are the embodiment of randomness.
It's like having the American culture explode in front of you and land all over the wall.
Language is what we deal with. That's the fabric.
For years, Phil didn't work.
No, and as you know, the Firesign Theater is doing its very best to convince all the wonderful, wonderful people out there that we are entering only into a period of economic impression, not depression. And we're here to laugh your blues away. Like in the 30s, stand up and sing. But stand up for yourself this time, dear friends, not for the government. That's me speaking personally.
That's why we work on records, too, you see. My name is George Plimpton, and I've made a great success out of records because people are free to buy them or not to buy them. There's no, you don't have to worry about turning off the record player, the television set. I mean, there's no decision to get up off the bed. If you buy a record, you're generally going to listen to it. That's why we've worked with Columbia Records and put out discs.
Tell them about it, Don.
Hello. I'm Don Giovanni, and I just like to... Oh, excuse me, here they are, the Firesign Theater, dear friends. This is what we do in our off-color moments, off-guarded moments. Over at Columbia, these are us, as you can tell here, and we're just full of good humor and good time.
Really see ourselves, I think that actually pictures are coming more and more into view, and it's beginning become difficult to see anything at all except pictures.
We like to have fun with the media too. Yes. I mean, you know.
All these things are...
Anybody, I'm talking to this camera right now and I can see my reflection in this orange filter, right? So everything I say is the truth only by being true. It's not real. It's not bigger than life. Just because I'm in your living room on your TV set doesn't mean anything. It doesn't mean anything.
The man behind the camera keeps squinting and closing one eye because he's looking through the machine, and he's also catching glimpses of the other reality through his left eye, which is real. See? Is it his legs or the tripod that's holding up the machine that's projecting me through your machine into your home? And what's holding you up?
It's all pretty funny, isn't it?
Block it! 4950 block job, players just spare, man of space, garage, don't junk it, just plug it down, right? Everything is truly not insane! Whoa!
But surrealism is basically the bending of reality and taking a premise as far out as you possibly can. And having fun.
This is Walter. I might just
These albums are for sale here, Bob. You can buy these in any record store. They make a wonderful. They got two sides on them. As you can see inside, they're black. Got a hole right through the center.
It's not a bad deal.
No, it's not a big deal either. We ought to know because we're Earl Shy. We'll stand on our head and give you a funnier record.
In your area.